What is up, everybody? It's Joe from JLW Games coming at you with another cool video slash live stream. And today we're back in Silver Dollar City and the Planet Coaster Recreation series. So today we're going to be working more on Outlaw Run and hopefully getting closer to completion on this part. So obviously we've worked on layout lately, we've worked on the barrel roll, we've been working on a little bit of terrain, we've been working on the station, and we've been working on a lot of different stuff, but today we're going to be focusing a lot on trying just to get everything done. And there's a couple things I do want to kind of get started off with, and the first and foremost is there's actually a fourth line of these, so I'm going to go ahead and edit the transfer thing, or the transfer table here, and because there's actually more than one of these, or there's actually four of these across, so we're going to need to get that completed here. Now, the only thing is I'm going to have to try and see how this is going to work, because I'm going to have to evenly space these out, so it's going to be kind of interesting to do that. So we're going to try and do our best we're going to have to move things around just a bit. And that's how we're going to get started. Trying to get this last one clicked. If it's okay if we can't. But we're going to go Control D. And most likely we're going to want to put it right here. Alright, so. And now instead of copying this one, we're just going to move it over to the right. And hopefully that will do what we want it to. So we're going to do Control D. Move it over. Oh, okay, never mind. I duplicated it. My bad. So we're going to go through and delete each piece here. Which is okay. It's not. There's not that much here. But. There we go. And get rid of all the footers here. And I'm trying to click on this little guy here. And you belong over there. There we go. Now that looks a little bit better. And it's pretty evenly spaced. This one could probably come over. Possibly by one. Actually, that would do quite nice things here. So we're going to move this one over just by one. Or at least half anyways. So let's move this over. So we're going to press move instead this time. All right, I still had the other one selected. Didn't want that selected. So we're going to go back and do this once again. Kind of get a hold of everything we possibly can. Move it over by one. Just like that. Alright, so let's not do that. Let's move you, and of course you're on a line to service. I don't want you onto a line to surface. Why would I want that? There we go. Same with this one. Actually, we'll just delete that and just do a Control X here. It's easier in the end just to do that, to be honest. Alright, let's get rid of this one. Control X. And that works. Alright, we fixed that now. And looks pretty good now. I did notice one thing, a minor thing, and that is that this bar is more on top. But that's not going to be a huge detail that we need to worry about. So there's also a little detail that I kind of want to add to this transfer as well. So if we go over here, and I bet we could actually use a wooden piece for this. I want to line it like this. We have angle snap on. Just want that tip perfectly aligned there. And we're going to make this... Go ahead and make this black. And I'm going to pull this bit this way. I want to make sure it's not going to be going through anywhere. That'll work. And we're going to place this across like this. This is actually kind of what it looks like. There's actually a kind of like a triangular piece right here. That kind of acts as where the wheels kind of stay on. And it is just a nice little piece of detailing to the transfer track itself. Now, the fun part is getting this on all of them. So I'm going to go in and carefully select all of them, and hopefully we can easily get it to slide over horizontally and have no issues there. No promises, but we're going to do our best to see. Yeah, there we go. We'll just slide you over, try and center you as best as we can. That looks good. Moving on to the next one. Almost there. And of course you would move over where exactly I don't want you to be. Perfect. Alright, Control X again. And we'll add it to the final one. Just like so. Alright, so now that we got the transfer track looking a little bit better, and there are quite a few other details that we can add as well, but I'm not entirely sure how I'm going to do it just yet. I could pull up some reference photos at the same time if I would like to, which I might just do and see if I can't find some good, because I did take one good transfer track reference photo while I was on it. Yeah, so it's kind of got like this little chain deal that does kind of help pull the car over, or the track over. And there's also another little silver kind of beam in the second to last one right here as well. Oh gosh. So I'm kind of zooming in, going to try and see what this looks like, trying to get some more details in. Let's see, what kind of piece could we use for this? Let's take a look in here. Preferably a attachable piece. It's kind of like a metal piece. Let's see what we can find here. I know we have our metal walls. Maybe if I, no, that's not gonna work very well. Not the way I need that to look. Alright, I think we're gonna come back to that, and I wanna focus on a couple of main other things that I, need to focus on, so. We're gonna move on to the next deal here, and that is this. I did do something off screen here, and that was actually lower this down a little bit, so this is actually level. That just is going to save me a lot of time of trying to figure this out, because otherwise it's going to be a huge pain otherwise. So I don't know what else I would actually do to get that. I would have to make changes to like everything otherwise, so we're just going to leave that the way it is, and lowering it makes our lives just a tad bit easier, trust me. So that's gonna be nice. I'm looking for my reference photo to get back onto the exit ramp here. If I can find my reference there. Okay, I think I found it. There we go, that's better. All right, so what we're gonna do, so I'm actually going to go to this building. I'm going to add another piece that will hopefully go right here. It's kind of cutting it hard. How this is gonna work. Alright, can't have that there. But we can have that about right there. And we're gonna want to get this connected with this as best as we can. And this is actually longer than the actual building itself, and so it is a little bit too long. So the building itself is just a little bit larger than what it would be in person. So that is a small inaccuracy there that we are going to have to live with. But there is a little pathway that goes there. And our goal here is going to be to get this connected. It's actually connected pretty much with this building right here. So a good way to get that connected is we're actually going to edit this building and see what we can actually accomplish. So let me take a look here. It should always be. Alright, so this is going to go about right here. This is not going to be completely even. But that's okay. What we're doing now is using all these as kind of guides. And we're going to delete these later. And we're actually going to use the actual planks here to actually cover all this up. So that's how we're going to actually approach this. Because we're going to make it have a slight angle upwards so it actually matches well with this. And to do that, we're going to be kind of messing with this a little bit. It's going to look a little bit sloppy-ish at first, but it will all come together at the once this is all done. My goal is to try and get this exit ramp finished. We got mainly the hardest parts done, so I want to try and get back into this and make this a little bit easier for us. So my goal is to try and make this as even as possible. We're going to place that here, and these are all guides, so nothing here is actually going to be, you know, final. Alright, so I'm going to take this, and I want it to be, find an even spot here. Oh, can I get you? I want it to face perfectly that way. Okay, that will work. That will work perfectly. Okay, so what we want to do is get this here, and we're going to use this straight section to use it as our incline there if I don't go in. So we're getting questions of what am I building right now. We're building the exit ramp on Outlaw Run here, which is coming together quite nicely. We're almost done with the station itself and the building and the queue sections and stuff like that. We're getting close to the home stretch of Outlaw Run here in this section. So hopefully we can get to the point where we can move on to other things. Alright, so these are all going to be guides. So what we're going to be doing here is I'm going to try and, since there's a slight elevation here, which there actually is in real life is at the same time, we're going to create an angle here. These are all guides, like I said. For those just joining, I'm just trying to repeat myself just so everyone knows. It does look kind of sloppy at the moment, and it's going to until I get this where I need it to be. So again, everything is literally just kind of a guide for the planks that I'm going to be adding on to here. And I don't know exactly how I'm going to get this angle. Oh, that's really close right there. Really, really, really close. If I can get it right there. You're just slightly over. Alright, so I'm gonna bend you just a bit. So what we want to do is actually probably bend this just a pinch and move this up and down until we're almost perfect. All right. So I'm going to place that there. We're going to double it up onto the other side. And these are guides to help us out. All right. When's the next Six Flags live stream or story park? I don't exactly know. I know I'm a little behind on where I'd want to be for Westwood, so I'm going to be hopefully focusing on Westwood a lot here soon. I'm not sure exactly exact times and stuff. For when I actually do those live streams, it's just if I don't feel like actually doing these live streams, certain live streams, if like I don't feel like doing that, I'm gonna do the Six Flags Park, or I'm gonna do Central Ridge, which is the story park. So it all just kind of varies, and it's kind of hard to determine what I'm gonna be doing in each day. Like, I was gonna do Westwood today, and then moments before I was like, I kind of feel like doing more Silver Dollar City today. So it's kind of one of those things that's just kind of like, I'm not entirely sure what I'm going to be doing. Alright, so this doesn't have to be 100% there, but I want to make sure it's pretty much 100% there. Okay, so this is going to all line up there, and we're going to have some angles here, which is okay. How long have you missed? Well, the stream only started about 17 and a half minutes ago, so you're not too bad. All I've done is kind of adjust the transfer table, and now we're working on the exit ramp here, which is, we're almost done with the stuff. You're heading to SDC on spring break. Make sure you stop by and say hi. Alright, so we're going to go back here to do this. Let's see if I can get the angle of these. There we go. Because that's the main thing. No, I didn't want to do that. So let's make sure angle snaps on, because I want to make sure this is straightly aligned with this. And now we just got to line it up with the previous ones here. So everything that's under here, I thought you lined that up. I guess it didn't. That's interesting. Where can we find you? You can find me at the best ride on park. I will give you that hint. follow my mouse. Alright. Excuse me, I had something in my throat there. I thought that... maybe that doesn't align with it. Because I want the angle. Maybe I have to... Oh, I know what I have to do. I know what I have to do, but it's going to be... I don't think it's possible. That's okay, we can eyeball it. Alright, so we're just going to eyeball it, which isn't going to be the best way to do it, but this is kind of a short spot, so it's not going to be too bad if we're not perfect. So what we're going to do is we'll line it up with the other ones here, kind of like so, and now we'll work on the angle. It's not going to be too bad because Everything under this is actually going to be deleted. Alright, so that should be good there. And if I move this up, perfect. Alright, so now we can just copy this and move it on down. And we have, this will turn out quite nicely. I might leave these down here, possibly, as long as it's, yeah. We'll see. We will see how it turns out after we get the these out here. Like, this one has to go because it's definitely interfering quite a bit there in that regard. There we go. Perfect. But actually today, I actually got to walk up the lift hill at the ride that I work at and actually hang out at the top of the lift hill. I would love to post pictures, but I could get in trouble with the company. But I do have some personal pictures that I always take every year. Just hanging out on top of a lift hill while the ride's not running. Absolutely the funnest thing in the world. It's a little windy up there today, so the structure was actually swaying a little bit. Always a little bit of fun and interesting when the wind's blowing. But I love just hanging out up there. The views are awesome. And we also, when we're at the top of the lift, we also sign at the very top with a little Sharpie as well. Because I do it every year because the Sharpie actually, it actually fades, ends up fading after a whole season with rain and all that jazz. All right, so this should all be level. Yeah. So let's see. Let's go ahead and duplicate this and do this. Let's not do that. Sorry, just don't listen to me. I want the angle snap on. So we're going to turn the angle snap on. All right, so this actually goes on. Let's see, when does the wooden planks end? I think it's about once you get to the end of the exit here. And then it just kind of cuts off into the regular concrete. Okay, I see. I see, about the straight part. And then once it turns over, it goes back to the concrete. So that's quite interesting. So, it actually cuts off about here, and then the rest is actually concrete. Oh, how am I gonna do that? Wish they had like a concrete version of this, almost. That'd be quite nice. Something I need to find. I don't know if I'm gonna be able to find something, but we're gonna look. It doesn't have to be perfect, but smooth concrete. I could use that, but I had a freeform one that the only way I could do that is if I made a separate building out of it and moved each piece accordingly. All right. So that's unknown where I'm going to do what I'm going to do with that. So I'm going to leave that blank for right now. And what we're going to do is create the fences that go around here. Let's go ahead and create the center fence first. I think that'll be a little bit easier, and then we'll get on the outside fences. Because the inner fence is, or the inside fence is actually a little bit easier to build. So what it's going to go ahead and use is pretty much how I made these fences over here. It's kind of like these green fences. A little bit different, but it will work just fine. We can just use this regular wooden pillar. We're going to start from the side here, just so I can get an accurate placement, because there is a... we're going to go with the smaller one, because I don't want it going through the bottom here. And we're going to give it that green, that beautiful green color. So, kind of a dark... It's kind of like a dark washed out green. That's pretty good right there. So I'm going to start this post. We're going to start this about in the center over here. That would make sense. And what we're going to do is build the first one. So make it about that long. And yeah, so I'm looking down at the pictures of what they look like. Now let's make some horizontal ones, which will go across like so. Let's see, I think I'm going to make it a little bit shorter. They're not that long, so. There's going to be a top piece, which will go up here. Let's keep to the short one. Oh boy, the construction over by Thunderation. By the way, I was over there today. Holy crap. I'm just gonna say that. That building is really rising up. And there are footers everywhere, I'll tell you that much. There are footers everywhere. This is so ridiculous. Thunderation's entrance has actually moved. They actually moved Thunderation's entrance. Can you believe that? I will say that. I was over by that area today, and they moved Thunderation's entrance to the right a little bit, so I don't think they're going to be using that huge zigzag line anymore. I actually think that's all blocked off. Like, literally, they moved the entrance of Thunderation to the right, and all that is like a huge wooden wall now blocking your view of what's over there. So you might get a good indication of where the entrance might be. It could be exactly right by Thunderation. You don't know. So that's kind of some interesting things going on over there. All right, so we're going to copy this down over here. That looks good. No, they haven't put any supports down or anything like that. all they have are footers and stuff like that. They have actually closed one of the employee parking lots. What do you mean they moved the entrance? They moved the entrance. Like, it used to be right here, and then they moved it to the right a little bit and actually made a new entrance queue, kind of connecting to the old queue line. So the new entrance is just to the right. They just literally took the sign off and moved it to the right. So as for the new ride, I don't know where this new project, where the entrance is going to be, but I would assume maybe either right next to Thunderation, because literally the station building for the new ride is going to be right there. They have announced that it is going to be a new ride, and that the official announcement will be in August. So, definitely be on the lookout for that. Alright, so now that I pretty much got that going, I can go ahead and start copying and putting this down the line. Hopefully I'm pretty centered. Yeah, there really wasn't much place to move it. they just squeezed it over to the right, which is kind of weird. And again, I think they pretty much removed the zigzag queue line that's at the beginning of Thunderation's entrance, and you go pretty much straight off to the under there now. I only got a glimpse of it because they were doing so much work in there currently, so I didn't walk up over there. But they literally moved the entrance just over to the right, and it's quite interesting how that looks. It looks it's kind of ridiculous how it looks. I don't know if they're gonna change it before opening, but it looks kind of weird because there's just this giant wooden wall out of nowhere that's just right there. That's so you couldn't see what's going on. But they literally closed employee parking lots just so they can store all the parts and stuff over there in that parking lot. I was actually in that parking lot because I didn't know they closed it down by today. And actually had to turn around in that parking lot. There's nothing over there yet, so. To be honest, I don't think we're going to see any supports or coaster tracks for another couple months, maybe. That's just what I think, But if you look closely, you can see that there are tons of footers all over, now. They've really started to gotten a lot of footers in there, and that building is getting huge, I will say that. Alright, we need to move this over just a little pinch more like that. Oh gosh, what did I do? All right, didn't want to do that, obviously. I don't know what I did. I'm confused. All right, I want this post. No, I don't. I want this post. Yes. And then no. Gosh darn it. This has an angle on it, so it's going to be kind of difficult to... Alright, we'll get this done. So we're going to go Control X. And then I'm going to... It's probably not this steep of an angle in real life. I mean, it's still angled, but it's not like this steep of an angle. And I'm not quite in the center. It's okay, these aren't very accurate in real life. They're actually kind of everywhere. They're kind of like not straight in real life anyways. So it's not a huge deal if we aren't super straight. And that's the beauty of Silver Dollar City, is that nothing's really perfect. And I love that about it. Oh gosh. We're going to have to line this up as best as we can. Let's twist you back straight over here. There we go. Now we just gotta line you all up. That looks good. Alright, we're almost there. We just gotta get it all the way down to the end down there. But, I hope you guys are having a fantastic day. I hope to, if not this episode, I hope to get this done very, very soon and move on to the next section. And, I probably won't finish it today because I still have to do all this path work over here a little bit, which shouldn't take too long, but I'm not sure. My goal today is to get this done and also the roof, getting the roof done on all this, everything here. So I want to get all these roofs done and stuff as well, and just kind of get everything enclosed and get it together. So that's going to be our main goal. So after I get this done, we'll work on the outside fences, which will be interesting as well. So we'll get the outside fences as well. And as well as it, as well, as well, as well, as well. So, again, recreations, you're never going to be the most accurate in the world. Well, we're going to do our darndest to be as... I'm going to do my darndest to be as accurate as possible when it comes to this recreation. And I think I've done a pretty good job so far. Pretty good start. Seems like everyone's doing... or thinks it's pretty good so far. Alright, so after this one, we're going to get it leveled out. So we're going to go over here. We're going to get you straightened out. Doesn't have to always be perfect. I went a little bit too far. Oh gosh, no. Didn't mean to do that. Where'd you go? Okay, there you are. Kind of changed up on me there. There we go. Let's make you nice and even. Might even rotate you just a pinch this way. Like so. Alright, good. And we should, once we get to here, there's actually these gates over here. The exit gate and also the disabled entrance that are on those sides, which I don't know how I'm going to make those yet, but we'll figure that out. Am I going to build any other rides in the live stream? I don't know. I mean, if you guys want me to, I can kind of work my way down this way and maybe even make the giant swing. I was thinking about making that in the same save file and everything. Because the giant swing probably won't be as hard and complex as Outlaw Run. Because it's mostly a square, you know, barn building and stuff like that. It's going to be pretty simple for the most part, at least I hope. Am I worried about the game being too laggy because of the extreme details? Yes, I am. I know it's going to happen, but the goal is to make the most detailed and most awesome thing I can. And for those that can't I'm going to upload it to the Steam Workshop, obviously, when it's done. And it's going to be probably super laggy for most people. You're going to have to probably have a pretty darn good computer to not have any lagginess, but I'm gonna make, my plans are to actually make, to make, you know, videos that won't be laggy so people can still enjoy it. Because I don't think it's gonna be impossible to make it where it's not gonna be any laggy whatsoever, but because that is gonna happen no matter what. There's nothing I'm gonna be able to do about it, because I know I'm doing a lot of detailing and making this very detailed, but I want to make sure it's the best recreation I can possibly make. And I might even upload each section as well that I do, so if I finish this, you know, I'm gonna save this as blueprints and move it over. And I'm gonna move it over, but I'm gonna keep this save, and I might even keep this save so you guys can check out each section. So that might also be kind of a little bit of a idea to save each section, because I'm actually gonna make these sections kind of like this, to where I'm gonna build it like this and then import it into the actual save. So before it's over, I might actually upload this to the Steam Workshop when I'm finished, so you guys can see the recreation of Outlaw Run just by itself. And it will be an Outlaw Run recreation, which will be really nice. And I could throw the giant swing in there as well. And then you can kind of get little bits and pieces kind of in that regard. So it'll be really, really neat. All right, so this will go here. And then let's rotate this way, and we'll have another piece here, and that should about do the middle railings, because that's looking pretty good, pretty darn good, pretty solid, not too bad. All right, so I'm gonna get another nice little Nice little reference photos here. All right, so the outside fences are going to be like this one right here. It's going to have the cross on it and everything like that. It's going to have the all that. So once we get one, we're going to try it out. When you're at SDC, I better keep Outlaw Run open. Well, it's worked out a lot of bugs, and you know, it's been pretty good. You've been waiting seven years for someone to successfully recreate Civil War City, and I surpassed that. Well, I'm not done yet. I have a lot to do. We're only on what, episode 11 of this, and we're almost got Outlaw Run going and done. And I can't wait to finish this section. It's gonna be really neat. And I'm going to feel pretty accomplished. There's a couple things I want to mess with the layout a little bit more. But the layout is getting very close. I figured out a little bit after some experimentation how to work on creating a little bit more of a heartline when it comes to inversions and stuff. So I might try it out on the barrel roll. That will help. I hope this is turning out very nice. Okie dokie. First time you rode Outlaw Run, it broke down at the end and we had to walk on the catwalk. So were you on the transfer track back here? I'd assume you were right here if you did it at the end. If so, I might have been there evacuating you. If I was there that day. Alright, so now we're going to get into, I'm going to try and see how I made this. What pieces did I use? I think I used the same thing. Yes. And I used the ladder because there's not really any good thing to put in there. And broke down is always kind of a strong word. It's not, most often than not, the ride actually doesn't break. Necessarily, it could be something else. But I'm gonna leave that there. Alright, these are actually about the same height as this, and I don't want to make it too tall. So, hopefully this will work out. I think it will. I think we'll be fine. Because I know opening year the ride had kind of some of its issues, but since then it's definitely gotten a lot better. Not perfect yet, but it's getting close to perfection. Like, there's been times where it's gone like a whole month without going down. And then of course there's been days where it was down all day. That's never fun. Oops, wrong, didn't want to do that. So what we're going to do is create the little triangular piece at the top. And this actually always turns out pretty decent, so get it on both sides. Now we're going to use the, has Outlaw Run my favorite ride at Silver Dollar City? Absolutely. Ain't no better ride. But I'll tell you this. The summertime, I will say this. During the summertime, we were down to one train. We couldn't run two trains. A lot of RMCs went down because they kind of had some recall on some parts. And different things like that. Well, Silver Dollar City, they save all their old parts, so we were able to open back up. And unfortunately, our sister park, Lightning Rod, could not. So what we did, we loaned some of our parts to Dollywood for Lightning Rod, so it could just open for a month. So we sacrificed our two trains so Lightning Rod could run a train. I will say that. That's how awesome Outlaw Run is. And I'll tell you what, those lines sucked. No fun at all. But hey, we got through it. Costed us some numbers and everything, but we got through it. Alright, let's make this. Alright, looks like it's gonna fit pretty fantastically perfect. So we'll just make this. Because there's not really anything better I can do. It's kind of like some white. And it's a lot thinner, but this is the best we can do right now with what we got, unfortunately. Nothing I could really do there. So we'll leave it. Alright, so we're going to go ahead and copy and paste this and get this going. At least we're going to try. And as for Kirawin's, on my bucket list to get over there and ride Fury 325 myself. That is on my bucket list, because everyone says it's the best coaster out there. But I'll be the judge of that. I will try and be the judge of that. Alright, I did miss a piece. The piece that does go across, but we can do that afterwards and just do that. You've been going to SDC since you were born? Well, me too. I am in that category as well. Which is awesome. Hopefully this will line up perfectly and not look too weird. But I would love to go to Kirawin someday. Don't know if I'll get out there this year. Probably not. But once I'm got a kajillion dollars and I can go to every park that I want to, hopefully that happens someday. I'll be over there. Trust me. Oh no, it's gonna be kind of awkward. That's okay, we can adjust. I don't know how we're gonna do this. So we're gonna place this piece over here as the corner. And now we'll just try and make this work. I still hate this glitch where it goes kind of like diagonal for your pieces. Kind of drives me nuts. But that's okay. We'll live. Alright, so now we're going to get these copied over. Oh, why are you diagonal? There's more than one selected. Usually if you select, like, I think up to three, it won't go diagonal. It's still going to go diagonal, though, because it doesn't not like me. Why must you do this? It's doing this just to annoy me, but that's okay. We will adjust. Alright, so it's starting to come together, and the exit is actually happening. So we got the disabled side on one side, and you got the actual exit on the other side. It also works as an observation dock as well. Okay, so we're going to continue on to this side, and get it all worked up over there. So I'm going to get a full thing selected here, along with that. We're going to go Control X. Of course I would still have that one selected. Of course. Again, Things don't want to do what I want them to. That's just Joe's luck. Alright, here we go. Now, this time is for realsies. Alright, we are going to head down this direction. And you're going to perfectly do what I tell you to. With no issues whatsoever. Ain't that right? Alright, that looks pretty good. Same thing for the next one. We'll go all the way about right here. Because then we're going to start going in a little bit of an angle. So let's rotate you. We're going to have to turn angle snap off. Make sure you're connected as best as possible. And we're going to get you down. Of course, you're not going to... You're not going to work properly with us. And we might get this to work as best as we can anyways. Brilliant. There's a little spot right there. Close enough. Alright, we still gotta do the inside and this right here as well. And it also goes all the way around this way at the same time. So, yay! I'm not a big fan of all these custom fences, to be honest. And I still have to add another detail to the custom fence as well. The little bar that goes across it, so. Alright, the good thing about these is I might just be able to copy and paste it and just drag it across over here. So I'm actually going to do that. I'm going to try and select as much as I can. So we're going to select those. And I'm going to try and deselect the stuff I don't want. Looks like that's all I have selected. So we're going to go Control X and see if that works. Yeah. Look at that. Look how brilliant we are. Alright, we might have to change the angle of this just slightly. Because I wasn't perfect, apparently. There we go. Alright, so now what we're going to try and do is I'm going to try and select as many of these as I can, and at least not as many as I can, just quite a few of them. That's what I thought would happen. Let's see if we can't get that perfect spot to where we can just do this. Alright, so I'm gonna get out of the flying camera now. What did I select here? Not even close to what I wanted to select. Alright, so let's just get a... We're just going to get a piece or a wall here or a fence here. Like so. And we're just going to drag it over here and use it for this side. Because it is the same kind of wall. Next thing, we do need to work a bit on the supports down here as well. That way it doesn't look under-supported. Alright, so we're going to build this across. Like so. Alright, so this is starting to look decent. Looking pretty good. Almost like the real thing. Almost like the real thing. There's also handrails, but I don't know if I'm going to add that detail or not for certain areas. Of course, I don't know exactly how I would actually add that in the first place. Alright, so what we're going to do is we're going to try and patch this up here somehow to where... Alright, so let's get this one at an angle. And we're going to do a little magic here to make this work out. At least, we're gonna try. So let's take the fence here. This part of the fence. We're just going to try and drag it over. That's kind of all messed up. Because it did do the diagonal crap again. Alright, we'll adjust things where we need it. Alright, so I'm going to adjust this to be further this direction. I might even make it kind of in this shape. We're going to grab this. Copy it. Yep, that's what I thought. I always forget what even had. I always forget to deselect what I had selected before. Whoa, come on, don't do this to me. The little diagonal glitches is just a little bit of annoyance to the point where I'm like, really? Really? But no matter. We can adjust and figure this out together. Alright, as for this, we're gonna select this part of the fence once again. And we're going to try and get this over here. It actually is not gonna fit in there too well. This is gonna be very tricky. Very tricky. Alright, let me get this. Alright, I actually want it lined up here. Let's go angle snap. This is the small one, so... Oh boy. Oh no. Oh no. I knew something like this would happen. I mean, I can put it here, but it's just gonna look like a completely jumbled mess right here. What is my favorite part on Outlaw Run? And that's a very good question. There's so many good elements here. The drop is fantastic. It's got a fantastic drop. It's got fantastic elements, like the 153 is absolutely amazing. I really like the 153 a lot, which is the 153 degree outside bank turn, for those that didn't know. The airtime in these sections are awesome. The wave turn is amazing. And then the barrel roll. Man, that's a tough one. That's a tough one. I don't know if I have a specific favorite part. To me, it's just all the way through, and it's fantastic all the way through. There's not really a bad part about this ride. And that's the thing. The first drop's amazing, but I don't know what I would go with. But the drop is an amazing drop. You know, the 81 degree drop at 162 feet tall is amazing. And it's a hard one to kind of figure out what you would like better. All right, I might kind of cheat here. This is going to be inaccurate. But I don't know. I really don't know what else I would do here. To be honest. Can't even tell it's there. But if you do know, Outlaw Run was the first ground up wooden coaster by RMC. It was pretty much their first coaster they ever designed from scratch, which is really cool itself, you know. And gosh, it's almost been an hour. It's been an hour already. Woo! Time is flying by when, because I'm thinking like, yeah, I could probably get all of this done, and here I am, hardly even finished with the first thing that I've pretty much been working on. Man, I'm slow. I am such a slow builder. It's not even funny. A lot of people get annoyed with it too. But as for me, I'm just like, I gotta make sure I do it right, and that's the most important part for me. Making sure I get this done correctly. Alright, so this is also gonna be at a little bit of an angle. I might put an extra piece there. And when I say a little bit of an angle, it's gonna be almost not even an angle because it's so small of an angle. Okay. Alright, we should be getting to the level spot here in just a moment. So we'll level you out there. I hope I made this proportionally correct. To be honest, I'm not entirely sure if I made these too big, too tall. To me, they look about right, and for real life. And I'm just hoping that's the case. Alright, so this is actually going to be kind of something I'm going to have to build by myself. Alright, so let's just go over here and do this. So we'll just go ahead and copy these, and everything will be beautiful. Okay, so I do kind of apologize that the lack of... I mean, I'm staying active on YouTube, it's just I'm getting a little less active, not like two videos a day like I was in February. But work has started up, and it causes these things. So, there's not too much I can do about it. But I'm going to do my best to get stuff out to you guys every day. And live streams are always easier because I don't have to edit anything. And you just get right into it. There's no editing. You just do it. And I've always felt it was kind of easier. And, you know, they're nice long videos, or nice and long as well, so. I don't even think I should even bother, like, much of the angle here. Shouldn't have done that. Should have stopped it right there. I messed her up again. Alright, so get you all selected. We'll do Control X and stop right here. There we go. I think we're gonna call it quits on the observation dock / exit ramp for right now and move on to something else. I think it looks fantastic. We gotta do a lot more of the supporting on it, obviously. We just got a couple of sticks supporting it, but I think it looks pretty good. What do you guys think? Does this look good? I mean, it looks pretty decent. I've never really done that much advanced building for, you know, fences and stuff, different things like that, but it's kind of interesting. It looks pretty good. I mean, it's not 100% accurate to the real thing, but it's pretty stinking close, in my opinion. So, what are the new additions to SDC this year? So, just because we didn't get a new ride, or they didn't get a new ride or anything, doesn't mean Silver Dollar City's not having anything new. So this year they're focusing more on food and crafts, stuff that makes the park unique, and I think it's actually really, really cool. So Silver Dollar City, they're calling it the year of food and crafts. They're going to have a lot more crafts this year, more than what you would usually see. And then as for food, they're going to be adding over 200 new menu items in the park. That is awesome, and I have tried some of the new foods. I actually got to sample a lot of them last season when they announced it, when they announced what's new for 2017, and I have to say a lot of them are really good. If you haven't had a fry bread out there, make sure you get to the fry bread company when you go in there for lunch. Fry bread is absolutely amazing. Those sandwiches are great, and they're actually adding a new one this year called Steak and Bacon. And if you guys love bacon, Silver Dollar City is going to be the place to be this year, I'll tell you that much. They're adding so many new different bacon stuff. It's insane. There's like chocolate covered bacon, which is kind of one of the weirder ones that are out there. They're adding a lot of unique foods this year, so you're not going to want to miss it if you're going to be around. So, it's going to be good. Like, I'm very excited for all the food. I'm going to have some fun with my lunches out there this year, it's going to be pretty delicious, to say the least. Pretty delish. But I think there another thing, crazy thing that was on there was like a cinnamon roll shake. Like, it's a shake and it's going to have, they're going to use cinnamon rolls. Like, what? And they're going to have a lot of stuff with bacon. There's a hot dog that's on its side that's wrapped in bacon. I think it's called like the bacon wrap burger dog or something like that. I don't exactly know, but or can't exactly remember, but it looks ridiculously ridiculous. Yeah, when you go to SDC, you may just gain about 50 pounds just from the food there this year. The food is going to be absolutely incredible this year, and I'm very excited to see a lot of the crafts too, you know, because Silver Dollar City is not all about, you know, the rides and attractions or all that stuff. They're also known a lot for, you know, the crafts that they make, and the crafts are really amazing. So I really encourage, if you guys are out there, to go check out in some of the gift shops, some of the shops out there. Some of those craftsmen are really talented, and they're really, really cool. There's a lot of pottery and stuff as well. Really, really good. But you're all going to be cleaning up a lot of vomit. I'm prepared this year. That is the truth, though. You're not lying there. I will do my best to clean those up very quickly so the ride is running properly. All right, so, man, I can't stop looking at this. This looks fantastic. Like, I'm pretty darn proud of how this turned out. Pretty darn proud. It's not completed yet. Got a couple details here and there, and there's also some lamps that are also... not present yet, just yet there as well. So those will also be in there. One thing I also wanted to do was the roof for the station. So I'm going to see if I can't get a good picture of that. On the inside, it looks like... Let's see... All right, I need a picture of the roof. Darn it. I actually got an aerial view today. What is all this? So the roof of Outlaw Run Station. I got an inside view. Let's see how that looks. All right, so that's going to turn out that way, so that's all right. And for the outside... Let's see one of the photos I took today. I might get a good idea or a good look at the roof. Yeah, there's a good one. I actually just took this reference photo today. So that actually will look pretty darn good. All right, so it's pretty much simple. There is a metal roof that goes right here. This one is lined up right there with that one. All right, so I got a little bit of... How does that work? So this goes that way a little bit. So I'm going to go and edit this building. What I'm going to do is go to roofs. I could possibly just use a normal roof. So what I'm going to do, it's a pretty gentle slope. We're going to just use this here for this. We're going to get rid of the grid size. And I'd say it's about 2 long this way. kind of like so. It's gonna be about right there. That's about where we're gonna be looking at here. So that's where that's gonna go. And then I was gonna make a custom roof for here. And to do that, we're gonna get to the. We're gonna use these wooden pieces, but we're gonna act as if they were kind of a metal-ish kind of texture to them. So we're gonna change them to a nice, beautiful silver kind of color. And these are gonna go like this. I'm just gonna go to about right here because it actually goes into the shop roof as well. And this roof actually slants all the way down past the storage building as well. So we're gonna start right here. And we're just gonna go. We're just gonna get into it. Let's make that just a pinch lower. Right there. As you can see, it gives a nice little texture. It kind of looks like a metal texture. Even though it is wood, it still looks pretty good. And I prefer to use this, or I have to use this, because the angle of this is actually a custom angle that I've made. So, it's a little bit different. Alright, so we're going to speed up the process by copying these and doing it this way. I found that it saves just a bit of time when you do it that way. Alright, so this roof pretty much merges into this one. Alright, so we're gonna get you all the way to the end. Let's just select one now since we're at the end here. Hopefully interior-wise this isn't gonna look too choppy or bad. That is kind of one of my fears. And inside's gonna look a little bit. Okay, so another thing that we're gonna do here is we're gonna select all these and we're just gonna move them to the top. And we'll have our first side. Because one of the main things I wanted to do today is start doing a little bit of the roof. Raising the roof up, and it will really give it a more complete feel. As we do reach near the end. This is one issue that I thought was gonna happen, but it's okay. As long as my aligning skills are decent here. Oh, look at that. Look how brilliant that was. Oh, almost completely flawless. Does anyone at work know that I'm recreating Silver Dollar City? Yep. Some of them have seen a couple of them. I've also posted a couple of things on my personal Facebook where they saw some pictures and stuff. So they're definitely aware that I'm building this. And I think a lot of them are pretty impressed so far. At least I hope. I'm pretty impressed with myself. Alright, so Control X. We're gonna try and cheat this out a little bit. And do it this way. My aligning skills are beautiful. Aren't they? Alright. Get those lines lined up, and we'll be in good shape. It's all key here. All right, so we got the top one. I'm going to do... Let's see. It doesn't matter. It won't matter in the end. It's not going to matter. All right. Perfectly aligned. It's not going to matter actually too much because this one's going to actually continue down over the storage building as well. There we go. Things are coming together. All right, let's take a look on the inside now, how this looks. Doesn't look too shabby. Because it does have an angled roof on the inside, and you can see the skeleton and everything of the roof on the inside as well. I want to do a lot of things on the inside as at the same time, so I want to make sure I have like all the props and different items like that around here as well. The operator's booth is a little definitely inaccurate because there's actually steps that's actually elevated up, so that's one thing to note. We're also, while I'm here, I'm going to go ahead and go into this building because it's starting to bug me because there is a little window right here for the operator to look out of. Of course, it's not that big. Let me see if I can find something very small that will fit this. It is kind of something more like this, but not looking like that. It's definitely not that big. It's a very small window here. Don't know if there's anything in-game I can do here or not. Let's go to the window tab. I guess I wasn't on the window tab. This is actually pretty... I'll take this. I'll take that one. I'll take this one. I want to make sure it's like completely aligned with the other side. Because there is a window right there for the operator to be able to view up the lift hill. So they can make sure everything is going smoothly while operating. Woo! How much longer am I going to be working on Outlaw Run? Until it's finished? Till it's done? honestly, I'm hoping it's not going to take much longer. We're getting to the final stages here. Got the roof on. We're almost done with the exit. This was a very long and tedious project or piece that I'm almost completely done, thankfully. I almost got that icky part down. There's a lot of different fences around. The roof on this won't be too bad. This fence is going to go around here and actually wrap around here. So yeah, anyways, we're getting to the final stage. We're starting to get to the final stages. I don't exactly know how many more episodes it's going to be exactly. I don't really want it to be more than two, because I do kind of want to move on to some new sections. But this is starting to look nice. There's not a whole lot of details, actually, you know, on this building or on the station itself, except for like this window. And then, of course, you got these little sections here, which I'm going to patch up a little bit more once I get more of the building of this building going up. So I can't wait for the April update myself. It's going to be really, hopefully, really good. That's the hopes, anyways. So, anyways, we'll work a little bit on the gift shop here. Let's get all these taken care of. Let's get all this taken care of here. I'm not going to worry too much on the terrain a bit because we're going to be importing this into another save. Which I'm going to have to redo the terrain. So that's going to be fun. Alright, so we can also, we also need to create the gift shop door on this side as well. So we're going to delete these. And we're going to place this on this side as well. So it's the exact same pretty much mirror as this. So we are literally going to cheat and copy all this. Because the doors are the same. Everything is pretty much the same. So I'm just going to use Control X, move it out over here, flip it around. Like so. And use it for this side as well. Now the door isn't actually this wide in real life. So I kind of covered up with the door to make it look like it's pretty much all the way open. And we can put it around right here. It will look good. Alright, so let's see. We could probably use a bit, do a bit more something like this. This is quite a bit out of proportion. This is a little bit too far out, but that's okay. We'll deal with it. Because this is probably, I made this building just a little bit too big. So, but that's alright. I don't think it's a huge, huge deal. And this is kind of the chicken exit, which has gotten very small. Alright, so that wall's kind of going through there, which is kind of a little bit of an issue. Alright, so there's actually steps that go down here. There's a door that will be right there. Fences have to be worked on just a bit right there. And I need to work a little bit on how the Trailblazer entrance is gonna go down here. And how that's all gonna work out. Alright, and then as for these, there's gonna be a this that goes. That's gonna go like this. Alright, so we just want to select these and we can... okay. Never mind. Come on, game. Can't ever work with me. But, let's see. I could probably get rid of that. And that will work out. Alright, so we're gonna continue this trend here. I mean, we could do one at a time here. Like that. Whoops, I clicked the wrong one. Nope. Oh, come on. Alright, that's starting to look good. Then after we get all the fences up, we are going to be getting rid of this. And as for community streams, I'm going to do them. They're not going to be something I do, like, you know, a ton. Hopefully, I'll probably be doing another one here very, very soon. Because you guys do seem to like the kind of like the community creations where I kind of show off some of your guys' stuff and kind of take a look at it myself. And Yeah, so, yeah, that's, yeah. I know it's been quite a bit since I did the last one, but what can I say? I'm really trying to get this going, and also Westwood is something that needs to happen very soon as well. So I want to hear from you guys. I think I did it on the last stream. Do you guys want to take a ride on Outlaw Run? It's not completed, so I don't really mind, you know, doing a POV of it. One quick thing, I'm going to actually start working a little bit on the track here. So I'm going to try and see if I can't help, but maybe work a little bit here and see if I can't get a little bit of a heart line going on. So it takes a lot of smoothing, a lot of stuff. I know the smooth tool kind of moves it back a little bit, but I'm still working on the shaping of the barrel roll a little bit. That's something that's hopefully over time I can shape up perfectly. But I know it actually does lag a little bit on POVs, but the last time I did it, it didn't lag. So you can cross your fingers, and hopefully it will work properly this time. I don't think we've really had any frame rate issues for the whole stream. As far as I know, it hasn't really lagged at all. So maybe the POV will work. We'll see. But let's go ahead and try and take a ride on this thing and see if it will work. I think I have the delay time on it. That way the trains actually will not move out until the other one comes back. So we're going to hop in here, and we're going to fast forward a bit. Yes, I want Westwood done very bad as well. Too bad it can't work on itself, though. Here we go. Are you brave enough to take a run through Outlaw Country? We'll see. Alright. And again, I hope you guys are aware that this isn't the final. I'm still working on the layouts. Still working on the track. There's going to be there's a lot of rough spots still. I was curious because I think I've worked on the 153 is not too bad. It could be worked on. Oh my gosh, it's so loud. I need to work on that little airtime hill too. See how the wave turn is. Not too bad. And the barrel roll obviously is very choppy. But it's better than what it used to be. Because I've been nonstop trying to have been working on this layout quite a bit. On the, a lot. The barrel roll is definitely a tough one to get perfect here, and I've been constantly trying to mess with it. You can see kind of the roughness if you look inside the barrel roll. You can kind of see the roughness in there, and we need to try and get that smoothed out. So I usually try to get in here and see if I can't fix it. So it's a lot of adjustments that are, you just gotta get in there and see what you can do. Try and heart lining it maybe a little bit. Now, I would smooth all the barrel roll at once, but I'm gonna show you exactly what it wants to do if I do that. And it is not pretty. So if I smooth it all at once, watch this. Kapow! It completely messes the whole thing up. So I can't, unfortunately, smooth it all at once, otherwise it gives us a little bit of issues here. So I'm gonna try and I usually just try and grab some pieces, drag them around a little bit, try and give it a little bit of a heart line effect, you know, try and maybe do that, raise other places, you know, kind of move them around. That's kind of my idea, is just trying to move these around until I get to that spot to where it's gonna be hopefully pretty close to perfect. And we're gonna get as close to perfect as we can. I've rebuilt this barrel roll I don't know how many times. You know, and then you do that, and then the combination of that and then a little bit of the smooth tool. And then we can start understanding. And then I get to the point where I'm like, maybe if I can rebuild the barrel roll again, or redo it. I'm getting a little bit close, so I've kind of gotten away from redoing the entire barrel roll again, so I'm trying to see if I can't do it what I can right now. See if I can't just adjust it and get it smooth. Alright, so let's take a look here. I think it's looking a lot better. Not 100%, obviously, but it's starting to get there. Slowly. Alright, let's take a look and see how it flows through here. Alright, I see kind of where it's going here. At the piece parts right here, it stays kind of straight for too long, if that makes sense. The upside down areas are actually very good. Maybe I need to adjust these a little bit. But I feel like it's straight right here too long, and it doesn't twist fast enough. Same with when it enters. It just kind of stays a little bit sideways for a bit too long. So there could be the possibility of me rebuilding it in a different way, but we'll see how that works. But shaping, it's starting to come together. Because this is a tough one to get smooth. It really is. Especially when you're sort of an amateurish, kind of like me. Oh, here it goes again. But you know what I mean? Like, just right here. If you could see that, it just seems like it's straight for too long. And the smooth tool... Oh, let's see. Let's see if that helps. It actually shortened it up there a little bit. Alright, now we're getting some action here in the smooth tool. It's actually doing something this time. A little bit. Alright, another section I kind of wanted to work on quite a bit is actually to make this taller. Because it is more... more of an airtime hill here. I think even if we lowered this down a bit, it could actually help out. And that's actually where the picture is taken on the ride as well. It's a little bit better. Because I was walking past this element earlier. and it's a little bit taller than that. And I have another idea of... Yeah, that's looking a lot better. I think I need to raise this up just a little bit as well. Just this old... whole piece, because I feel like it travels upwards to this section just a little bit too much. Like, I feel like this is just too much here. So we'll pick it up, smooth it out a bit, and I think it'll be looks pretty good. So Alright, so that's looking pretty a lot better. And we're shaping this up just a little bit better. I think that's a little bit closer. Not 100% yet, but... Alright, so that's why I always have issues trying to get this smooth. Or smooth that piece out, because I don't want it to change the angle too much. Because it's at 153 degrees, and that's where it needs to be. So I think what I'm going to do is go in here. We're going to smooth this. Press the smooth button on this quite a bit. And it goes through that at a pretty accurate speed, I think. And this twist and turn and hop is just pretty insane as well. And the wave turn. The last hop, and then the turn into the barrel roll. Alright, so this section's bugging me a lot. I need to make this shorter. But how do I do it? I might end up rebuilding the barrel roll again. Don't really want to, but I'm probably going to end up doing it again. When it's all said and done, and in the end, all that stuff. Alright, so I noticed that was a little bit off, so we'll smooth that out. Alright, so... That looks good there. Alright, go back to the 153 here. And we're going to make sure... Oh gosh. This is 153 degrees. Wait for it. There we go. That's close. Or good. Good enough. Doesn't have to be perfect. As long as it's within 153 degrees. Alright, the transition here just seems a little bit sketchy. Kind of like blocky-ish. So maybe we can adjust that a little bit. I feel like this turns a bit sharper in real life, too. Just kind of like, boom. There we go. And then I just twist you all the way to the other way. Other time. Will SDC recreation be live streamed until it's done? I've thought about different things. I'm not entirely sure how I'm going to do it fully. It might be off and on, you know. Certain times I'll live stream it, certain times I won't. So it will kind of be kind of determined whether I feel like doing it or not. It just kind of depends. So it'll kind of be back and forth. But yeah, I mean... We didn't get a whole lot as far as I wanted to completed. Alright, I'm going to go ahead and ride it again. Just to kind of see where we're at. And to see if I made it any smoother. Wait for it. Wait. Alright, here we go. Alright, hopefully it's not going to be laggy again. Hopefully it won't be laggy this time. I don't think it was laggy last time, so that's good. I don't think it was, anyways. Alright, here we go. Test again. Test number 563. Yeah, I like how that turns a little bit better. Alright, a little bit smoother, nice. Hop and turn. That seems a lot more accurate there. Oh my. We'll get it there. We'll get that barrel roll down. We'll get that barrel roll down. If it's the last thing I do, I'll get that barrel roll down. Nice and perfect. We'll get it. I promise. But how's it look visually? Does it look good? Would you believe you're at Outlaw Run? Oh my gosh, where'd all these guys come from? Oh, it's open. Why are we open? Interesting. Alright, so this is kind of like the wood chipped area. So I tried to do my best to make it look like wood chips. It's never going to be perfect, but maybe I can go in here and I'll do my best, but I don't know how this is going to turn out. I'm going to try and go into shapes here. I'm going to do my best to maybe try and make a test seat here. It's probably going to look terrible. But we're gonna give it a go. Because the test seat is right here. Alright, so it actually has two seats to it on their test seat. Alright, and let's just make a back for right now. Let's make you nice and vertical. This is absolutely pitiful. This is not no test seat. Alright, let's try and move this back a little bit. This is absolutely... This is not going well for me. I don't know how to make an RMC test seat. It's not going. Look at that. That's the perfect RMC test seat. I kind of stopped for right now because I don't know if I could make that any better. But I see you guys talking about collabs, and I'm definitely open for collabs. Like I really am. But it's just a matter of thing. Is it something that we could properly do? You know. Because collabs are always fun because you can learn from each other. I'm trying to figure out what to do next. I mean, I got plenty of reference photos and all that jazzy stuff, all that nice stuff. Because I get to certain points where I'm just like, I'm kind of blown out right now and just need to take a break from it and move on and call it an episode. So that's kind of, that always kind of determines where I'm at. I don't know if you guys can plan of what we can do for a collaboration. I mean, I'm all for it. I don't exactly know how it would work properly because I've never done anything like that. So I don't know how you would pass the files on to another person and stuff like that. But I don't know if we'd want to build a full park or if we would just work on maybe a ride with a lot of scenery and details, but you know, but it looks a lot more complete. It definitely does. That's why we're gonna save. It is why we're going to save. Sweet. I still need to work a little bit on this stagecoach. I'm not gonna do it here because it's already a blueprint. I could create my own blueprint, I guess. So maybe. Yeah. So the only thing that's do not have a roof right now is pretty much the gift shop and, sorry, I went blank there for a second, and the storage building for maintenance, and literally this is just going to continue down and cover this up. That's how that's going to work. Through the workshop, I see. But how would that work exactly? I guess it could work. Didn't realize that you could actually do it that way. But I've never done a collaboration before, and if I was to do one, I kind of want to, maybe we should start a little bit on, you know, on a smaller scale. If we're going to build a park, you know, maybe make, depending on how many people are involved, do different sections. Like, I'll do, you know, I get my own section of the park, you get your own section of the park, and you put it in one. I think that would be fun. Or through email. I mean, we could do a three-way collab. I would not mind that. So if you guys want to go ahead and get it started and, you know, just make me aware of what it is and maybe we can, and get started from there and just kind of go and, make our own sections and stuff. That'd be a lot of fun. I would definitely love to do it. But, maybe a little bit more planning before we get into it, but, I don't exactly know how it'd work out, because I've never done it before, and I don't know exactly how it worked out. I haven't really been working on anything in the last probably 10, 15 minutes of this park, or this section, so, kind of, just because I'm kind of trying to figure out, like, what do I want to do, so, but, anyone that's interested in doing a collab with me, I mean, just personal message me and stuff like that, to be honest. We can kind of do it through maybe personal YouTube messages or something like that. Just a little bit. I don't know who would all be involved. I don't know what's our max of how many people would want to do it. But anyways, when I'm up for anything, if you guys want me to work on a project with any of you guys, I'd be happy to do it. Hand me the file, tell me what I'm doing and what you want me to do, and I'll definitely give, obviously, credit, and if I make videos on it, I'll definitely give you guys credit, and it'll give me more, some new content for my channel anyways, so... I'll definitely promote, whoever does it with me, but, we'll do that when, we'll figure all that out through personal messaging and stuff like that, so that's how I'm gonna approach that, so, anyways, but I appreciate it. Community collabs does sound awesome, and I would love to feature it on my channel as well, so, and credit everyone that's, is involved, so, if we want to get that together, well, let's just do it through some personal messaging on YouTube, and do it in that manner. So that will be kind of that. So I think for this last couple minutes of the live stream, let's just kind of explore and take a look of how this is looking. I haven't worked on anything in a while. I think I'm kind of done with building for right now. So I'm going in. We're coming to Outlaw Run. I wish we had some. I still wish we had those signs where it doesn't actually have a background. It's actually just the words. That would definitely be useful. And this rock actually works very perfectly for this sign, for the Outlaw Run sign. So, and then we had this little cowboy thing that actually worked pretty close to what the Outlaw Run logo looks like, in a way. So, that's cool. A lot of different stuff to work on. But there's the stagecoach, and here's the stagecoach depot. We can enter through here. I actually have a real queue line, which I'll actually get rid of all those railings and stuff. As for Google Hangouts, I don't really know if I've heard any of those, but but anyways, you'll walk through here, go through all your queue lines, which obviously is under construction. Go through the last one here. We'll go down here. Now we're to the entrance area, to the loading area, and here we are. And this is the Trailblazer entrance for people that purchased a Trailblazer in, as well. All right, let's try going up the lift, if I don't get myself stuck. So we're running up the lift very quickly because we're that fast. Oh gosh. All right, look at this view. Oh my gosh, I'm stuck. I got myself stuck. Oh my. So you get a good view up here. Actually, looking here, I can tell that I've already made some inaccuracies because I feel like the wave turn is actually a little bit further the back. But that is my... All right, we're stuck on the lift hill. No good. All right, let's test. I got stuck on the railing of the lift. Okay, there we go. Oh, no. Get back down. There we go. All right, let's not mess this up this time. We're going to get back on dock. Let's see how the exit works. All right, the exit's on the right side. So we're on the observation dock. On the observation deck. Pretty awesome. Alright, but one would go through here, and then they would exit through the gift shop. If they want to go look at their photo, they can. Man, I got this kind of incorrect because I made this building too big, but that's okay. And we would come out here, run around, and go through the entrance if we would wanted to ride again. Is there a glow to that sign? It feels like it. Passengers only. Man, I'm excited for this recreation. I can't wait till I finish this. I know it's going to be a long road. Going to be a long time before I get it all the way completed, but I'm pretty stoked. Like, I'm pretty stoked for this. Wow. Because I'm looking at this and I'm just like, man, that looks pretty darn good. I did a pretty good job there. So the height stick used to be actually right here, for the measuring, but they actually moved it this year to this post right here. So. That's also a good note. What does it look like at night? I mean, probably very dark because I don't have many lights out here. Looks about like this, apparently. I guess I do have quite a few lights around here. Looking quite nice. I still haven't put any of the lights in the extended queue line yet, unfortunately. I said stoked, not stoned. Not stoned, stoked. I'm pretty sure that I said stoked. Yep, definitely gotta get some lights in here. There's actually, let's see, is it under scenery? But it's actually a chandelier. I might actually be able to make this. I'm gonna test it right now on the first one. My goodness, this has to be pretty high up. This honestly is low enough. How high do you have to have it? My goodness, that has to be high up. Which kind of sucks, because it does kind of suck, because it actually is not that high. Darn. Darn you limitations. Why must there be limits to what I can build sometimes? Not cool. Anyways, there's chandeliers here, and there's actually like a wagon wheels kind of that actually go around here. If I can actually find them, they should be under Western. Right here. And I'd say we'd be using the larger one. Kind of like that. Yeah, those are definitely. And that actually fits perfectly into these. So that's kind of what those are going to look like. But they actually, in between, actually have some normal lights too, because they are... gets a little bit too dark. Or it's not bright enough with just the chandeliers. So they actually did throw some regular lights in here as well. Kind of like this. Kind of every other one. So we're going to put one there. And we can put one... Put one here as well. And that alone will pretty much lighten the station up. Woo! Alright, so we get that. There we go. Perfect. And we will add these. I don't exactly know how many of these are of these. I actually forgot. See if we can't get this in here. Since it doesn't want to be straight. Or move to the straight spot. I think there's more than what I'm making, but it'll be good. It'll be alright. Since it won't let me go any lower either, we have to deal with this. And there we go. The interior is starting to look good. Starting to look nice at night. Did make it pretty bright in here though. I only put two of those lights in here. But that's all right. And we have... let's go ahead and save this. Save. Outlaw run. Okay. Nice. Alright, We got some pretty productive things done, especially this, the exit ramp and everything that's, was gonna definitely be a pain, and we got most of it done, so that's an accomplishment. Hey, Jess. Jess has decided to join, even though I'm about to end. But anyways, I really appreciate everyone coming around and joining me tonight. And I love the change the color of the lights. What lights? These lights? Because those the other lights are actually white. There's so many different lights, I don't know which lights you're talking about. But those are actually just regular lights in real life. But, yeah, I guess I could change the... make it a little bit dimmer. That's right. I got you, bro. So make them not as bright. It's a good idea. Didn't ever think of that. I'm gonna test that real quick. Yeah, it actually is a little better, I think. Thanks. And AM. Awesome. But, yeah. So it's been an awesome stream. We've done a lot, but we're at, like, the 2-hour mark right at this point, so, that's a good, pretty good stopping point, so, probably the next stream will either be something random or something, you know, something else, it's most likely will be, back to Westwood, because we have a lot of work to do still on Westwood, and I definitely need to get that park, going, and pretty much finishing that up soon. I have all the time in the world. All the time in the world to get this completed, so I need to focus on those projects, but I love working on these as well, so. But anyways. Set the roof by the sign on fire. What? What are you talking about, Jess? What are we setting on fire? Why are we setting stuff on fire? Oh my. Oh my goodness. But anyways, thank you. I'm just like watching the chat. I don't even know what's happening right now. It's just ridiculous. But anyways, thank you guys so much for watching. Make sure you comment, like, and subscribe for more content like this. Sorry. Quick question. Sorry, before I end it. Do they change the hay bales out in the station? As far as I know, no, they don't, actually. And I actually need to get those in there that are actually on the top there. But no, they actually do not. So anyways, thank you guys so much for watching. Make sure you comment, like, subscribe for more content like this, and I'll catch you guys next time. Make sure you have a great day and an even cooler tomorrow, and I will catch you guys next time. Thank you guys so much, and goodbye.